ORCID is a persistent digital identifier that is free to you, which you own and control, and that distinguishes you from every other researcher or scholar, especially those who may share your surname. If you want to learn more about the ORCID organization, its mission and values, you can visit this link that you see on the screen. An ORCID ID helps you to stand out from the crowd. You might be wondering, why do I need an ORCID? You can use your ORCID to connect with your professional information, affiliations, grants, publications, and peer reviews and more. You can also use your ORCID ID to share your information with other systems, ensuring that you get recognition for all your contributions, which will save you time and effort and reduce the risk of errors. In addition to the benefit of being distinguished from every other researcher or scholar, you can enjoy these additional benefits. Your research outputs and activities, contributions and affiliations will be reliably and easily connected to you. You'll save time when filling out forms, and you'll have improved discoverability and recognition. In addition, you'll be able to connect your record to a growing number of institutions, funders, and publishers. If you're interested in who these trusted partners are with the ORCID organization, you can visit your account settings and get more information about them. So you can easily distinguish yourself with your ORCID in these three ways. You want to claim and register your ORCID, use it in a couple of different ways, and then there's some suggestions for how you can share. So to begin, you go to the ORCID website, as you see here, their registration page, and you'll see a form something like this. Here, you will first enter your personal information, your first name and last name, although that's last name is optional, but you do need to indicate an email address and confirm that email address. The next part is to indicate security for your record and notification. So you're going to create a password with these parameters. And then you have the option of signing up for quarterly emails from ORCID, but that's totally optional. Then your visibility settings are totally within your control. It can be public. You can share only with trusted organizations, or you can make your record private and visible only to you. Then you need to accept the terms of use and click register. And that's really it. Now you have a basic record you can use to enhance with information like your employment and educational history, distinctions, memberships, funding, and primarily your publications and works. You'll also be able to indicate links to other platforms where your work can be found and keywords you want viewers to know about the work that you're doing. So here's an example we can take a look at, just so you can see what this looks like. Jorge Hirsch was the creator of the H-Index. And here we can take a look at his record. You'll see the ORCID ID, some keywords that he indicated, linked to his Scopus author ID, employment and educational history, and then an extensive list of works. And you can see the source of the information. This is one of those trusted partners, Crossref. So that's basically what this record will look like. You also have the ability to add information manually. So there's a lot of functionality. So that's step one in claiming your ORCID. The next thing is you want to think about ways to use it. Primarily, you'll use your ORCID when applying for a grant or submitting a manuscript for publication by supplying your ORCID ID that ensures that work is connected to your ORCID record. In communications, it's a best practice to use your ORCID in all your professional communications and include it in your email signature. Finally, there are ways to share your ORCID ID with other systems. At Georgia Southern, Plum Analytics is integrated with Digital Commons, our institutional repository. Also, products like Clarivate's EndNote Manuscript Matcher and the Mendeley Reference Manager provide the ability to connect to your ORCID record. A note about Georgia Southern's repository and the ORCID. There isn't an automatic way to import your ORCID data, so it it isn't authenticated, but Digital Commons through the Selected Works profiling system allows you to enter that manually. So here's a link to get you to where you can learn more about that. Some additional resources and a further reading. If you want to know more about ORCID, here's a link. They also have training videos on the researchers menu. There are FAQs and other resources, and an article with six things you can do right now with an ORCID ID. So that's the end of this mini tutorial. If you have questions about setting up your ORCID or any other scholarly communications questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. I am the scholarly communications librarian at Georgia Southern. Here is my email address, or you can request a consultation if you'd like to have a one-on-one conversation about your work and building your research identity.